of Valkyrie Chronicles, I realized that I didn't go to headquarters to... Which seems very odd that I can do this. I didn't go to the headquarters to do any of the RD facility stuff, or the... anything, really. So I figured, hey, I'll show you guys, like, look at all this progress that we've made. Like, the strongest rival only does 42 and 60. My DLC does so much better. But it's come a long way in terms of our weapons. And I do like how the final ones are all, like, they're all slightly different than the ones right before them. I just took that the longest possible way. And these post, like, I have to imagine that's, like, new game plus upgrades, like, for these. Because we're in the finale chapter. Okay, don't know where else you can go with this. Fallen grenade upgrade, which is good. God, I can still remember. I can still remember going through the DLC so many times to just get to level 11 or level 10 with the level 11 with the scouts to get the grenade launcher. Drive system. I'm not gonna equip it, but. It's like, I don't have enough space for something like that. I mean, of course I get that, like, every upgrade you're supposed to... Like, because it's so much better than all the previous upgrades... Like, you're supposed to rearrange to try and equip it in, but it's like, I don't want to go through that time. Because the equip and unequip of the modules is so tedious, because you have to go to it, then you have to hit A into it, then you, when you're in the module, you have to hit B, and then you come back out of it, and it's just like, you can't just go down the list and unequip all the things. Each action takes a little bit of time, and then, not only that, there's also a slight amount of, like, lag to it. So, like this, hit A, then it highlights, hits B. Hit A, then it goes in there, and then you hit A, and then it's equipped. There's a second lag. Yeah, you can't just go down hitting like Y or something to unequip everything, and it really sucks. Because I would more than happily play that jigsaw puzzle, but when it's so tedious. And there's so much, emergency militia draft called. Gallon government issued that. The draft encompasses everyone aged 15 to 29 as well as 30 to 45. Because of its grave ramifications for Gallia's economy, only Princess Cordelia possesses the constitutional right to enact their draft. Princess, however, has not been seen in public since her appearance at a parliamentary meeting last month. Rumors from within Castle suggest she may be seriously ill. Okay. Yeah, so... Douchebag Magoo is holding Cordelia, essentially hostage. And now, let's get let's hope we get lucky with the War Cemetery. And if not, oh well. Hi.
I'm sorry.
No, you're useless to me. I want to shoot your spine all over that wall. Audience Hall. How funny is this? This is comical. That I'm able to do this. This is breaking the canon of the story so much. Or not even the canon, just the continuity of the story all way too much. Would have broken even more if I had gone here before last mission. Where it's like, oh, we need to make it to Casa Rangri's. We're here. Hey, Queen, what's up? I'm just gonna head back out and then complain about how I need to get to you. Cool. Would have been funnin'. Fucking hilarious. Okay. So. Now let's see. The real Cordelia.
Your Highness honors me with an audience. I offer my thanks. We Maximilians stand humbly before you. Your Highness, you must allow me to apologize for the somewhat brutish manner of my entrance to your domains.
We'd expect no less from Europa's premier commander, the great Maximilian. To cross our sovereign border with such lightning speed. Your tactics are admirable.
And you are the one they call Borg. You attempt to ally yourself with the Federation. Then you turn over a new leaf and become the Empire's informant.
It is all to ensure that Gallia remain a stable nation, of course. Ours is a small land, as you know. Our fate is made secure by such agreements. The sovereign state of Gallia will accept unconditional surrender and become a vassal state to your empire. In return, by our treaty, and your grace's favor, I, your humble servant Borg, will rule Gallia in your stead.
I'm afraid you're mistaken. What use could we possibly have for Gallia as a vassal state? We, Maximilian, shall be the one to assume the Archduchy, and then Gallia shall be made anew under us.
But we agreed.
Then as sole master of this palace, we shall wake the lance that lies resting within its walls, Valkov, the key to ruling all Europa.
The lance? How could you know?
My dear princess, Cordelia, you shall serve as our bride. The Valkyrian bloodline, legacy of the great House Rongris, would be a fitting dowry for us, King of Europa.
The Valkyrian bloodline? I see. You wish to ransom Europa with its power.
Indeed. The reverence and respect the people of this continent hold for that ancient blood is undiminished to this day.
Well then. I hate to disappoint you, but this is the true face of House Rongris.
Your Highness, what are you doing? That's impossible.
Really?
Yo, she's Darkseid.
As you can see, my blood is not Valkyrian. It is Darkseid.
Princess, what is the meaning of this?
I mean...
Thousands of years passed. The Valkyrie invaded from the north to lay claim to Europa. The indigenous people, the Darkseid tribes, fought them for control of this land. But the powers of Ragnite they possessed were too great. The Darkseid cities were burned. The struggle continued, though its conclusion was clear. Ultimately, one influential clan among the Darkseid tribes defected to the Valkyrie side. The Darkseid were defeated and quickly became slaves to the Valkyrie.
And victorious, the Valkyrie authored history to blame Darkseid for scorching the earth. Of course. Then the descendants of that clan of treacherous Darksons lived on as...
Yes, as House Rongris, the Archdukes of Gallia. In return for their betrayal, the Valkyrie established them as the rulers of Gallia. We donned the identity of our masters and were complicit in the Darkseid slander.
With a perfect scapegoat, the people quickly acquiesced to new rule. A common tale
that has caused me much grief. To face my people deceptively has pained me. Until the day came that I ran from that pain, trading my free will for comfort. Were it not for a single officer's words, I would no doubt still be lost in that conceit. I am bound by neither fate nor duty to obey the false blood within me. I live by my own will. I live for the sake of Gallia and its people. This, and this alone, is my calling.
All the more reason to be my bride.
No, for the sake of my people, I shall see you dead!
What delightful barbarism. Do all Gallian brides share your lust for blood? If you desire safety for your people, it would behoove you to obey me, Highness. The Valkoff is in my possession. To see your homeland burn again, that would be a shame.
Damn. See, I'm saying, okay, why would she try and use a knife? Surely she could hide a gun in all those sleeves or something. Like, and that Prime Minister idiot, he could have helped, because, you know, he's essentially dead. Because he's not ruined when Maximilian takes over, so why would he even care? So let's do the optional ones.
Has something happened? What's all the commotion?
It's them. The Imperial Army invaded Ramgrease.
What?
They crashed through the city walls with a huge tank and drove it into the castle. And now they're doing some kind of work on the tank still half stuck into the castle.
Work on that? Did they learn of the Valkoff's location? No. I can't afford to wait around here. Sorry, but...
My chest... It's tight. It hurts.
Hmm? What? What's wrong?
My heart. Help me.
Are you all right? Hey, talk to me.
I'm sorry.
Let go of me.
Got to get to Ramgrease. I just hope I'm in time.
Okay, so I'm hoping there's some redemptions in with Faldeo. Okay, so what's going on here?
We're drawing close to Ramgrease now. As for our plan of attack, once we arrive, focus your attacks on the spot damaged by Sergeant Melchiot in the previous battle. Exploit that, gain access to the interior, and destroy the Dreadnought's engine. Follow?
Yes, Captain.
I'm confident you can do this, soldiers. You are dismissed.
Quite a risky operation.
I know. I'm worried about morale if everyone feels like it's a suicide mission.
We're used to your crazy missions by now, aren't we, guys?
Yeah, you bet. Nothing bothers me anymore now.
And it helps to know that if we can just win this one, our war will be over.
We'll do it for Isara, and all the other friends we lost along the way.
And for all of Gallia's people.
One more victory, and they'll have peace.
Words fail me. Thank you.
All right. Everybody, get ready to deploy.
Almost showtime, huh, Welkin? Militia rides into Ramgrease Showdown. Mind if I put y'all's story on the radio? I'm afraid I can't go help you fight. But I'd like to do what I can to stand by you. As ace journalist Irene Ellett.
Okay, why not? Our activities are hardly a secret to the Empire at this point. Irene Ellett, huh? I can't remember ever hearing your full name like that.
At least until the war ends and I get married. Then I'll be Irene Kohler, just FYI.
Hey, she's the author of the War Front book that's always recited from.
This'll be my last big assignment as an Ellett. Time to do the old name proud.
Okay, stowaway. Stowaway.
give me a status report on affixing the lance.
Work should be complete shortly, followed by final testing, sir.
Good. Keep it moving along, soldier.
Yes, sir.
I knew it. They came to the capital to get at the Valkov.
Bastards. You won't have it.
For some reason, this thought just hit me. I find it interesting that they don't seem to have pistols in this world. It's always rifles or snipers or lances. They don't have, like, handguns. I feel like that would actually be very useful.
General Jaeger is defeated! Now the militia is headed here to Rangreese even as we speak!
What?
Newsflash from Radio GBS, your source for the news.
Now that we're in the hangar, I wonder if they're ever going to use the plane. Hans is a thing. Forgot about that.
Reckon I did a fair job whipping those kids into shape.
I will agree. You got us to level 20, bud.
Citizens of Gallia, keep your faith alive. Turn and face the threat ahead and fight.
Go, Welkies, go. We're all cheering for you. Make us proud.
That's like a 6-month-year-old? God. Oh my god, that's a great quote right there. A 6-month-year-old.
Lel'jin, if you're watching up there, your son could probably use a little help.
Hey, how about you go fuck off, old man? You could've helped me. Get out of my car, old man! I'm glad that fuck's gonna die, Borg. God, the main Tau pillar is the fucking weapon. So cool. The Valkov.
Marmota sighted ahead, sir. Range, 4,000 meters.
What's that big pointy thing on top?
just like the Valkyrian lance, the one that Alicia carried. Look out, Sevens! Clear the Marmota's forward path! Move it!
The Gallian militia has fanned out ahead of us in a line, sir. Range, 4,000 meters.
They say that in antiquity, the Valkyra called upon Valkoff's light to crush and subjugate the entire Darksin tribe. The greatest weapon of all time. Fashioned into something as pedestrian as a castle tower. How could they have known? And now it awakens, shouldered by the Marmota we have engineered to bear it, a leviathan upon the land. Now, know the futility of your struggles. Bow before the terrible light that once scorched the earth.
The Marmota's fired an unidentified beam of light. Squads 4 and 5 have been wiped out.
Hot damn. If we'd been one step slower, we'd be a big pile of dust by now.
Stay clear of the front of that thing. Move around to its side.
Dare you face us yet after that display? We wield power enough to bring any foe to his knees. This is the future face of warfare. To impress the magnitude of our power upon the world, you shall all die gruesomely. Now, cross us if you dare. Our history of unrivaled glory begins here.
Join us in Valkyria Chronicles 2. Oh, wow. Oh, God, it has two battles. Shit. This is a long chapter. Holy crap. Okay, let's save. Ugh. I'm not gonna have many saves to work with. Okay. So, we've just gone through like 20 minutes of cutscenes.
Here are the details on this operation.
Cool. Okay, so we have to probably climb up on board that thing. Your squad thankfully managed to avoid that blast and is currently stationed at the Marmota's side. You may not be so lucky next time, this may be our only chance to destroy that beast. It's now or never. Your target is the area along the Dreadnought side that the Valkyria previously damaged. You could just say Alicia. The opposition consists of cannons mounted on the ship's side and endless waves of troops from the front hatch. So, station teams at the Dreadnought's front and side, which will work in tandem to stop the enemy. The ultimate objective here is to destroy that giant lance. That said, it's protected by a shell of light. Nothing we've done so much as far as dented it. Begin by hammering at that damaged plating. We need a point of entry before we can do anything else. I think it's safe to say you face a battle unlike any fought since the dawn of war. I trust your judgment out there. Okay. So this is presumably just Welkin. This or Zaka. This is a big one. So, time for Carl. Gonna put Marina there. Gonna also have Claudia out. Largo to do some damage to the side of the thing. Elisa for moves and killing people. Rosie for moves and killing people. Actually gonna take Jean out as well, and then I'm gonna take Ted, because Ted is my homeboy. Okay, so deploy.
Our reclaiming the capital hinges on this. Concentrate your fire on that dreadnought and destroy it.
Okay.
Our target is the Marmota. Sink it at all costs. Squad 7, move out.
The reason why I took Marina and not Oscar is because, in case I have to pick off ground units. Okay.
Here we are.
actually squaring off against the Marmota.
Yeah, this will really be the final battle.
Lieutenant Gunther, are you all right?
Princess Cordelia, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know I may just be in the way, but I wish to be of assistance however I am able. I wish to fight as well. Allow me to stand in defense of my homeland.
I understand. We'd be honored to have your help in the rear guard. Here's the plan. Start by focusing our fire on the whole Alicia's lance main.
Okay.
The dreadnought's side is lined with cannons, though, so you'll need to be careful.
Okay.
Roger.
Also, tanks can use the depression in front of the Marmota to fire upward.
Cool.
Right. I'm on it.
We've come through a lot of tight spots, Sevens. Believe in yourselves. I know we can do this.
That's Squad 7, move out. My bad. Okay. So that's the Edelweiss, these guys. I need to take out that sniper. Maybe I should have taken Oscar. Take out these fucks. That's the Shamrock. Anti-tank turrets. Okay. I have no idea what to do first. Wait. Are you friendly tanks? Three shots to kill each of these Gatling things. Ugh.
Now!
There. You out.
Sweet dreams.
Good work. Keep it up.
Okay. So that's an anti-tank. It's Gatling.
Leave it to me.
I'm actually rather stupid because I should have been using Largo from the get-go, because instead of using two, it's a little bit further away.
Here, have a couple.
Good.
You're done.
Forward. Okay, gonna try Largo one more time. I'm hoping that possibly the being closer is something enough. Okay. And now what I need to do is. It's hard to tell what I need to do. Because I don't want to leave my back open to this Lancer back here. But I don't think Marina's going to be able to take him out.
The hunt begins.
I mean, I should try.
Checkmate.
Oh, she will be able to. That's good.
Sweet dreams.
Okay. Okay, cool. Wasn't sure if we'd be able to do it. Okay. Now there are only shock troopers over there. And a trooper there. A lancer there. It's so hard to tell what to do. I'm gonna move her into this. Take out this lancer.
Sweet dreams.
Yeah, close that. Okay, so let's see how that goes. I'm hoping that no one dies. Cause I'm not sure how this is supposed to go. Because I understand that those ladders are there so foot soldiers can go up and probably drop a grenade on them, but... Oh, fuck you! Fucking... Their enemy lancers get so fucking... I'm actually gonna start again from the briefing, because I want to use... I want to see how Oscar would do. Because I don't think I need two mechanics. I think one's probably safe enough. So I'm actually going to take Marina, once again go there. This time I'm going to take Oscar, put him there. Carl should be good around here. Largo's still close. I'm going to have John right there. And put Alicia right there. Who else did I have? Rosie here. And actually, I am going to have a second mechanic there to keep the snipers and the tanks healed and the lancers, like, all up on ammo and whatnot.
Squad 7, move out!
Yeah. That's what I'll do. God, one fucking tank shot, and that's all it took. Okay. I don't know what you do. You're rather useless. So what I have here are anti-tank, and you were a shock trooper. You weren't a lancer. Okay, anti-tank, that's a Gatling. My objective is to see that the Valkoff is destroyed. Left heat sink. Where's the right heat sink? This thing has, what, 21,000? Can't hit me. So, first things first, I'm gonna take Marina, kill the people that I had previously killed, because I need them dead. Okay, that's good. Gonna end there. What I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna save right here. Save for that. Feeling rather confident in my choice of people. I just need to make sure that... Oh god, yeah. Another extra shot.
Sweet dreams.
Okay. Now with this movement, I'm gonna come over here. I'm gonna do that. Now. Move a little bit forward. Not gonna mind that damage. Gonna take him out. Take out all the visible lancers. Now, I'm actually going to save right there, because save over this one. Now, the real question is, do I want to use my tanks to try and get these things out? Or do I want to try and experiment, because these ladders are here so I can get a foot soldier up, instead of trying to fire at them from the ground with Jean and... So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna do a little experiment. I'm going to try and run up to one with Alicia and use a grenade. And then I'll just reload if it doesn't work.
Think you can stop me?
Okay, that's very useful that you have that.
Make sure you stay calm.
Okay.
All that destruction from one blast.
I didn't do anything. What the hell?
Don't give up now.
What do you want from me? Can I just ascend here right now?
Take a deep breath and look at your surroundings.
Okay, I'm gonna end, I'm gonna reload. Because that didn't work. I'm not just gonna waste a turn now. So that was relatively dumb. I'm gonna try with Jean, because her thing is stronger, whereas Largo's is a little bit more accurate. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use all three of her things to initially damage those Gatling guns. I'm gonna do another save. And then I'm going to use Largo's to finish him off with his more accurate.
You got it, hon.
Okay, and this one.
Hit,
okay, good. End that action. And now that is done, I'm going to system save. Over that one, and now I'm going to use Largo to take him out.
Here, have a couple.
Okay, that's one.
We'll be there in a minute. Hold out till then. Been waiting here.
This is two. Actually gonna save after this one. Save before this one. Over that one again.
Been waiting here.
And then
your joke is still all right.
Use this. Ah, shit. It requires two. Okay. Double damage proc.
You're done!
Damn it! It's at fucking 24 health. Nothing I can really do about that. But, yes, I'm going to end that action. Luckily, I saved right before it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to system load. I'm save timing for the best possible end result for this first turn. Okay, so he hasn't gone for this. This one's still alive. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take Carl.
I'll do my best. I refuse to let it end here.
Okay, that's good. I'm gonna stand. Reload you. Oh, he's just not taking damage. That's fucking awesome. Reload you. And then I'm going to end turn here. Now with that, these guys both have their full ammos back, so I'm gonna save. This time, I'd say this is... I'm gonna save over the top one again, because I did plan on reloading these guys anyway, but because I reloaded them now, the one they use now this turn, they're getting back at the beginning of next turn. Good. So now, Gatling turrets out of the way. Now the only remaining ones are the anti-tank ones. End turn there. Hope everything goes better than it did last time, with the random Lancer coming from nowhere. Yeah, fucking random Lancer left the base. I couldn't even see.
Underminer fire.
Okay. This fuck. Okay.
Minor damage sustained.
Fuck. God damn it.
So
I literally put him there to intercept fire. Fucking weakling shit ass doesn't fire until they're literally on top of him.
Underminer fire.
Now I have to get rid of those guys. Hoping this guy comes like right up in between the two so I can mortar fire them. Of course not. Fucker trying to get my sniper. Really? Fucking anti-tank turret. Tax Marina. Oh, and I still have Oscar. I wanted to try killing the artillery things with Oscar. So you know what? I'll do that. Because I think I can see the heat sinks. Like the things that make the power go from this angle, but what I'm gonna do is first of all, it's really dependent. Do I wanna use a mortar on these guys, or do I want to try and do it with Alicia? Well. This is actually a very tough option, because I don't know what I want to do. I'm going to use Rosie.
Ain't no stopping me! Medic!
Because I need to clear this out so Claudia can pull in. I'm pulling here because I'm going to use her again, and I'm going to try and get them both. Nope.
Here I come.
Oh my god, really?
Ain't no stopping me.
Fucking bitch, couldn't put a few more stray bullets in? The maximum amount of turns. Great.
New target sighted.
And I have to get rid of that Lancer. Oh yeah, that double attack would have been useful last time. Because that's one of her potentials. She can just attack again. Okay. Now I need to use Claudia. Now I don't have to worry about moving, at least.
Medic!
Yep. Yep, yep, yep.
Keep that monster away from the capital.
Heal.
Thank you.
Leave her there. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to save. I'll save over this one, because at this point I'm not going back to that first turn. I want to check to see how much Oscar does to the anti-tanks. Okay, so it takes 8 shots with Oscar. It's not bad, per se. And I need to do damage to the plating, like the damaged plating, to get inside. It takes 5 shots to... Oh, so there's a weak point on it. Where's the weak point on this one? Oh, it's in the slot hole. Okay, I can accept that. Okay. So I'll take that amount of damage. Use Alicia to come over here, take out the Lancer.
Come in. I repeat, come in.
Because this Lancer is very not good for my tank. There's one straight shot, and it could potentially hit. Back behind this tank so I don't get destroyed by an anti-tank shell. And now the system save over it again. God, this is so much more stressful than I thought it was gonna be. Okay, sup bitch. 2 shots. So it's gonna take 2 shots regardless. I should do it. To the one that doesn't have any damage. Oh, and it doubled. Good. Really? You missed? Okay. Gotta reload that. Because I can't not do damage on a turn. Great. Even proc double damage. What the hell's up, John?
Sure.
Jan?
Have you ever seen muscles like these before?
Yes, I have. I've also seen people better at aiming than you before. But you don't see me being impressed. Okay. You proc'd it again. That's good. Okay. I guess I hit an area of it where it didn't necessarily kill it. Okay, so now this one is slightly... Okay. Use him or her again. And I only have 2 shots. Okay. So both of these are almost dead. I'm going to save. And now I'm going to use Largo. Because I need it to be as accurate as possible. So this one is going to take 2 shots. What? And this one would take 3? Why is this thing so weak comparatively? Yes, good. Hit it in the tiny spot that allowed for. Okay, that's good. I'm just waiting. I want to get rid of all these cannons before I go for the damage plating. And because of the surprise that the amount of not damage Largo does, and use Jean again, and use their last shot to just take him out. That way, my tanks and whatnot are in a lot less danger, and I won't have to use 2 turns to do damage to the plating. Okay, so 1 shock trooper came as reinforcements. That's not bad. Unfortunately, Rosie's probably gonna kick the bucket here because she's not looking the right way. And they threw a grenade. Luckily, where are they? say firing. Okay.
I wish to be of assistance, however I am able.
Okay. Oh, so you heal. That's really nice, actually. Okay. So are there any people that I need out now? Okay, so Rosie's probably going to be on whatchamacallem duty. Reinforcement duty from now on. So what I'm going to do is actually... Now I'm going to pull out Carl again, and now I'm going to pull out Ted.
Let's do this then.
Use Rosie. Immediately go into firing. Murder this bastard. Okay. Now you're looking the right way, which is good. And I'm going to save right now. I want to see how much damage Jean does to the plating.
You ever seen Margo? You're the only man for me.
Okay. Damaged plating.
You're my muscles.
I don't think. Is this technically a tank? Okay, that's good. And now my people can get in.
We've blown open the damaged area on the Marmota's side. Yes, the plating on that spot was vulnerable after all. Sir, part of the side plating damaged in that explosion appears usable as a foothold. You're right. It looks like we could climb up from there. Judging from its design, the Ragnite drive system is likely near the propellers. If foot soldiers could get at those to attack them, they may be able to do further damage. Okay, let's go with that plan of attack.
Okay. So that's a trooper right there. I think next turn I'm gonna try and hit the Ragnite drives, which you can sort of see from the edge. Actually, okay, I'm gonna save right here. What I'm doing is I'm gonna use Oscar and see whether or not I can actually damage him, whether or not I'm actually looking at the right thing. Okay, I don't think I am, actually. Two shots with an anti-tank rifle.
Keep them away from the capital.
Whatever. Might as well just headshot them.
Stupid Imperials!
Get him to turn a little bit. Wish I still had Marina, but... Oh well.
My turn, okay?
Alicia. I wanted him to turn a little bit so he wouldn't be looking right at the stairs. Before I go up again, I'm actually gonna wait here because I don't know what's up there and I can't attack if there's anything I need. So I'm gonna use another turn, climb, enter. Okay, so this seems to be fine. Him out. So that's the left heat sink. I'm probably standing underneath the right heat sink. That's an anti-tank turret. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to see whether or not I can damage this. can't do damage to those. Presumably without grenades. So I'm going to end my turn there. And I'm going to save. There. What I will do is I will actually... I'm going to move Largo up there. Because he'll be able to do damage to heat sinks. Okay, come on, get up there, bitch. Sure if that did any damage. I don't assume so. But I'm just gonna get that move back anyway. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave that here. Okay, reinforcements have appeared. Another Lancer. But my tank is turned at such a way where a Lancer's not going to get a stray shot to the crit
damage
zone.
Minimal.
Which is nice.
Minor damage sustained.
Okay, they have a sniper now. Actually, it's very terrible for me. Luckily, they don't aim for headshots. What is nice is that I'm getting my characters now. Okay. So, now I'm going to use Rosie. Push forward a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to... now that I'm here, I'm going to... In fact, I'm going to set Rosie up, like, right here. Because she has defense, they're just spawning, and she needs to be in range of them when shit goes down. So now I'm going to use Ted to go over there, take out the Lancer. Ted's now going to be the reinforcement Lancer killer. Because they're doing damage to the tank that doesn't need to happen. And it's just an unneeded risk. So might as well just have it covered. I'll just leave... here and here. Okay. I'm gonna use Claudia to heal the tank. And I'm gonna now put her on the safe side of the tank because I don't want her getting sniped by any enemy reinforcements. So now, right now, I'm gonna use Alicia. Oh, okay. That's what it is. That's the left heat sink. That makes a lot more sense. I was wondering why I couldn't see it. Okay. That means I moved Largo up here for no reason, because Alicia's going to be able to do it. And that's why the enemy is facing in this direction. Like, it has the arrow. I didn't realize that. Now the Valkov can't fire anymore, I believe.
Look! The light surrounding that giant lance is gone!
It looks like destroying the drive system powering the propellers has paid off!
good. If we can just destroy that lance, the Marmota will be defanged. Listen up, Sevens. Your orders are to direct all attacks at that lance's tip. Tanks, use the incline at the Marmota's front. Ground units, aim high and let fly.
Okay. So, we need to aim at the Marmota's tip. Okay, so now I'm gonna save. System, save. Save over that. There's a thunderstorm going on outside. Okay, so I'm wondering if I can hit the Marmota's tip from here. Shasta kill 42. That's not bad. Double tank damage. Okay.
You're done.
I mean, it's not supposed to be really fast. Okay, so we're supposed to put the tanks in those things. What I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna take Jean.
You got it, hon.
And
you ever seen muscles like these before?
And go up there with Largo and Alicia. Because
what was that attack?
From the ground, you'll be less accurate. Then I'm probably gonna move Carl up there to keep them both fully stocked during the assault on Yeah. That's a much better choice. So I'm gonna move Carl right now. So I'm not sure if he's gonna be able to make it, but I want him present. And if he does make it, then he's restoring one of the ammos of Sean. But it doesn't look like he's gonna make it. Which isn't bad. One could even argue that's a better thing. So I'm still not sure if they're able to fire here. John.
You ever seen muscles like these before?
Die for me, sweetie. And it's nice because the entire circle fits into the lance, so I can't miss. Okay, and I'm gonna save right here because I don't want all this to go to waste.
You got it, hon.
I'm not sure how long the battle's gone on. But this episode is going to be over an hour. All these episodes are going to be in over an hour. It was funny, because when I started doing, like, my YouTube videos, in my brain I was like, oh yeah, I'm going to do, like, 30-minute episodes, maybe even 20-minute episodes. Just, like, boom, 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 get all through, get, like, be very pro about it, like, get through it really quickly. And then I get to making videos. Oh. Wow. I didn't know it could do that. Shit. Forgot that you weren't. Okay. I'm not worried about him.
Damage minimal.
But it's like, I'm gonna boom, 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 like just do it real quick, do it real professional, like, and I get to doing Disgaea 5. I get to, and now she's not looking the right way. God damn it, fuckers. Okay, that's fan-tucking-fastic. Okay, so, first of all, I want to go save Rosie.
I love playing you a full house.
Just because I feel like I should.
Hi,
all honesty, after you know that, like, just destroying the Gatling guns is the key to this mission. And after it, it's not very complicated or hard. Especially after you figure out where the heat sinks are. Okay. So now, let's use Jean again. Okay. Now I need to use Carl.
I'll do my best. I refuse to let it end here.
See, that's a good potential where you just, like, after you get that, you don't take damage. So, okay, I'll move him out of the way again. Now, it's Jean. A few more times. Boink. One more shot. Man, it is raining cats and dogs outside. I did get a flood warning earlier on my phone. Luckily, it was right before I got the warning right before I hit record, and I was like, good thing I did not hit record.
Enemy dreadnought destroyed. Repeat, enemy dreadnought destroyed.
Oh, but good job, guys. We destroyed a super tank with an A rank. Damn. I can't imagine how you could do it faster. Because you can't really ignore. Well, actually, I guess you could kind of ignore the Gatling guns.
Okay, let's find the engine and kill it.
That would be most inconvenient.
Maximilian, show yourself!
What?
The finest engineers of the Empire shed both blood and tears to forge this Valkyrian shield and spear. As you will observe, their powers exceed even the originals.
Stop this! Haven't enough men died? Why are you doing this?
Why we fight for our dream? Do you not think that reason enough? So many have died for less. Besides, we must. Rightful vengeance must be meted out.
What is this?
We were born an imperial prince, but our mother was of low station. For this, our father shunned us. The other heirs saw us as a threat to their ascension. They bombed our train when we were but a child. Though we survived by some cruel miracle, the fates were not so kind to mother and the rest. On that day, we swore an oath. We would take the Empire and the Emperor's throne for our own.
If you wanted that, why would you let your actual Valkyria die? It seems so stupid. Okay, so I'm gonna save over the command mode. Okay, with this, I'm gonna end this episode. We'll do this next map and the cutscenes later. Because this episode is already quite long, and I don't feel like saying it's through another cutscene and then leaving it out on a map. So, with that, I will see you guys in the next episode, and I hope you all have a very nice day.